Hello everyone, JBarrow here and welcome to mini guide number 5. This time it is going to be about Jim's Phoenix Glacier style in Protoss against Stern. This is one of my favorite builds to use because it deals with drops very well and it's something different than we've seen for quite a while. So hopefully you will enjoy this guide. There are two openers you can use for this build. I will be using the one that looks like a regular one gate expand for example. The complete build orders for both openers will be in the description. So you open with a normal 1 gate expand with a 14 gas, and get your second gas right after the Nexus. You get a Stalker, and then a Stargate as soon as you can afford it. After that you get another Stalker, and an Oracle shortly after. You can get your Robo as soon as you can afford it, and add 2 more gases after that. Shortly after that you add 2 more gateways. You want to make sure you get 2 Observers out of your Robo. Now is when your Oracle comes into play. It should arrive at your opponent's base. Sometimes you can get some Worker skills, and sometimes it won't do anything. Usually the Reaper will scout your Stargate and a Terran will be prepared. You use the Oracle now to scout whether your opponent is going for a 2 or 3 barracks play or is going for a Widowmine drop. If you're playing against a Widowmine drop or a Hellion drop, you should start Phoenix production right away, warp in Stalkers from your warp gate and get multiple Observers. If you scouted a Widowmine drop fast enough, you should be able to deny the Medvac from entering your base, else use your Stalkers and Photon Overcharge to lose as few probes as possible. If you are playing against normal barracks play, you want to get a Robo Bay as soon as your Robo is done and delay your Phoenix production until later. You also want to get a Sentry on top of your ramp in case the Terran tries to do a bio push. After you make the Robo Bay, you want to add 2 more gateways. Right now you should be on minimum 2 bay saturation and start to warp in Zealots. As soon as your Robo Bay finishes, you want to start Colossus production right away. If you can afford it, start Phoenix production before your Robo Bay is done. You really want to be able to afford your first Colossus right away though. This is how the early game should roughly look like. Your main focus after this is to deflect the 10 minute timing push with Medvacs, which is likely to happen. Once you have more than 5 Phoenix, you can start to chase and kill Medvacs. In between 10 and 12 minutes is when you're most vulnerable with this build. Your Phoenix count is too low to effectively deal with drops. You heavily rely on your first couple of Colossi to deal with any bio push, and you only have non-charged Zealots, so it's really difficult to push back the bio. If you're forced to engage the Terran army, make sure you place your Phoenix where the Vikings are. As soon as the Vikings are dead, try to lift the Marauders. Keeping your Colossi alive is your main priority. At this point in the game, you just want to sit back and try to scout your opponent with Observers. Like any other Protoss versus Terran build, I recommend taking your third base after you see your opponent's third command center, if you aren't sure when to take a third base. If your opponent isn't taking a third base, but rather adding more barracks, you want to make sure you see the SCV pool coming. Because the Colossus is your only area of effect, and you're not going to have charge, you need to add cannons in your natural to hold a bio push with SCVs pulled. When you take a third base and you have a good Phoenix count, you can start taking map control with the Phoenix and spread pylons around the map that can intercept drops. Be careful with your Phoenix if you decide to harass the Terran's base. Upgraded Marines in small numbers are surprisingly good against Phoenix. With this build you get your second Robo much faster than with other Protoss against Terran builds. I recommend getting it before you reach full saturation on your third base. Meanwhile you add Double Forge and a Twilight Council. Getting charge is extremely important because your Zealots are the only units you will get in the mid game besides Colossi and Phoenix. So after you are comfortable in 3 bases and perhaps deflected some drops or bio pushes, it's time to scout your opponent some more. The main things you want to be scouting for is whether your opponent is going for a second starboard and whether your opponent is going for a Ghost Academy. You always want to match your opponent's infrastructure when it comes to air units, so when you see a second starport, you should get a second Stargate right away. If your opponent has a reactor on a second starport as well, I recommend starting your air upgrades a bit earlier. Normally you would want to stop at around 15 Phoenix. This will deal with normal Viking to Marine Marauder Medvac ratios. However, you should try to scout your opponent's army consistently to see if he's making more Vikings than usual. You also want to make sure your Phoenix can deal with the Vikings since it's your only anti-air. When your opponent doesn't go for Ghost, you slowly want to replace your Zealot buffer with Archons. This will help with anti-air as well. When you scout a Ghost Academy, I recommend only getting Colossi and Phoenix as much as your gas income allows you. I've seen Jim and other people add Archons and High Templar against Ghost. I've had more success with pure Colossi and Phoenix though. You have to make sure you don't clump your Phoenix though. EMPs will cause you to lose the air battle. The late game really revolves around scouting your opponent's army composition, while being aggressive with Zealot warp-ins and Phoenix harass, or defending drops and run-bys. In the early game it's the most important to get your infrastructure in time to defend against early bio pushes. In the mid-game, you want your Phoenix to be as active as possible, while at the same time defend your Colossi from Vikings, so make sure you have the map control to see attacks coming. If you still have the Oracle from the early game, use Revelation. Hey guys, thanks for watching this episode of Mini Guides. Make sure to subscribe and share the video if you think it was useful. I didn't really get to talk about everything I wanted to talk about for this build, because it's quite an in-depth build and it's hard to squeeze it in a video under 10 minutes, so I recommend watching some first-person VODs or download some replays in the link below to get the full idea of the build and see how a game actually turns out when it comes to the late game. I'll probably be uploading some replay analysis of the style as well, so make sure to check out my YouTube throughout this week. Other than that, thanks again for watching, and hopefully I'll see you next time. Hey guys, JPower here, and welcome to Mini Guide number 4. This week I will be teaching you a Blink Stalker Alin in PvC. It's gonna be a bit of a shorter mini guide this week, because I can't like teach macro builds or macro openers every single game and go a bit more in depth about how to react to certain things. So there will be some Alins during these small guides, but I think this is a good guide to a good build to practice your Blink Stalker control. And you know, it's good as a protoss to have these builds in your inventory, so to speak. So hopefully.